Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, a retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. I'm not a theologian who went to university to study the dead letters and came out as super donkeys carrying holy books are drunk with the old wine of the dead letters, desiring not the new. I'm a new skin, capable of taking the new wine. The old skin cannot take the new wine. I go to Oxford University, and over there there's a Christ Church Cathedral. And I attended some time, and I asked the dean over there, do you know why Jesus was called Yeshua? He had no idea. So I told him, bring paper, I will explain to you. So he bring paper, and I told him Yeshua is made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother, and Joseph foster father. Then I asked him, do you understand now? No, I will go home after a cup of tea, then I will look into the books where it is written what you are saying. That means their ears, they are hardened with the wax, hard wax. They can't hear. That's why Jesus put a finger in the ear of the person who was stumbling or who was not allowed to speak. Then he spoke. The rabbis, they won't let you speak. They were rulers. Under Jesus, we have the freedom, free will, no binding at all. So here I'm rendering exposition of John 10, verse 1 to 10. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, same thing. Delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi, my native language, we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. That dwells within his temple, this is the temple of God, created by the demiurge potter, the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, etc. And it is called Harmandir. This is called Harmandir, or Emmanuel. God is with us if you are not cheating people. If you are loving Mammon, as Judas Iscariot was stealing money from the church purse. And at Last Supper, Jesus told him to go and do his own job, and then he baptized the rest of the 11. And in Holy Spirit. Eucharist is the baptism of Jesus in Holy Spirit, is highly mocked today. So you can see what type of Christianity is today. Jesus said, Amen, Amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold, Church of God, where the royal priest ponder over his word through the narrow gate, that does not allow the blasphemers like Ananias and Sapphira that Peter killed, but climbs over elsewhere without being Mammon-free, is a thief and a robber. So Peter was the one who was told to feed the sheep, and that is how he fed the church with the good quality sheep, Mammon-free. robber, these hireling dog-collared priests in the churches. These churches are the synagogue of Satan, fulfilling Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, creating sectarian riots. As you can see them in Northern Ireland, Catholic and Protestant and all that thing. In India we have the same. But whoever enters through the narrow gate with a childlike heart. Childlike heart means what is inside is outside. No hypocrisy. It's the shepherd, apostle of the sheep. Apostle of the sheep. That means only those can become preachers who are free of mammon. That's why Jesus said, when you go on preaching tour, don't take any money in your pocket. No two shoes, no two tunic, and no script. Script being Bible is forbidden. Bible are letters. And our covenant with Jesus is of Holy Spirit and not of the dead letters. Letters finished with John the Baptist. So here is the covenant of Christ Jesus. There is John the Baptist holding scripture by scripture here. He was Prophet Elijah, the cornerstone of the temple, and he was thrown out. And the temple priest who were rejected by the sons of man that John the Baptist baptized, they rejected those temple priests. They had become the cornerstone. They replaced him. So he was thrown into the wilderness. So he was baptizing Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham and Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. And they who came to John the Baptist, they realized that when they become Jew of physical self, and not of heart, they break their covenant with Abraham. They become unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh. That is called tares. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. They were called tares. So tares, the temple priests were creating tares. Jew outwardly, whereas John the Baptist baptized them in the name of Abraham, making them Jew inwardly and tribal people outwardly, establishing their covenant with their forefather Abraham. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, because Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical self. People of Judah tribe, Levi tribe, they were born, they died in the Holocaust, led by their blind guides. And today they are getting them in Israel for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 is being fulfilled. So these people, scripture here only, letters. And they were the ones who turned their seed into plant by burying the ego of their seed. Remember St. James the Just, he used to tell them that in Christ Jesus, in God, there is neither Jew nor Gentile. We are all equal. And those temple priests, they were very clever. So they told St. James the Just, at next Passover, you go on the pinnacle and announce, tell everyone that we are equal. There is neither Jew nor Gentile. Oh, very good. I will do so. So he went there at Passover to announce, and then those very priest, clever one, they told their student, hey, look, this man is making Jew equal to Gentile. We are superior, elite people. And those stooges, they went up and they killed Jesus, the same type of stooges. They went up and threw him down. And he broke his legs and somebody killed him. So, clever people who are misusing the spirit. So they are evil-spirited people. And so here, the scripture ends here, let us. So you must turn the seed into plant, and plant is twice born. That will bear fruit, not seed. So then you pass through this burning bush and graft yourself to the true vine, Christ Jesus. Here your spiritual self, soul is concerned. Here your physical body is concerned, not soul. Here you become son of man, and here you become son of God. Son of God, all in Jesus said, we are one Father. Here you can't say any other person a Father. These people in the Orthodox Church who call themselves Father, they are anti-Christ. They put Bible in the hand of Jesus and apostles. Here our covenant is of Holy Spirit. That's why Jesus told me, no take money in your pocket, no two shoe, no two tunic, or no scrip. And no scrip means Bible is forbidden by the preachers. Preaching comes from your heart. So this is of heart. So here we are, all soul is concerned, whether you are male or female, the same soul. And soul represents our supernatural Father. So here you are the sons of the Most High. And we are fishers of men and not of women. There's no woman here. All are men. Woman and man is here in flesh. John the Baptist never baptized a Gentile, a woman, or a Samaritan, only the Jewish men. So you can see how much corruption is there in Christianity. So this is the above celestial world of sadhus, Melchizedek. Melchizedek sadhu, they don't have any caste. They don't have any tribal identity. They have left the tribal identity here. Buried it down, the ego. So this is the above and this is below. So this is the burning bush. That is what Jesus said, I bring fire to bake your fate. This is raw break, raw fate, raw fate. This is a fired fate, fired fate. So much more in my other videos, let's carry on, you know. Otherwise, I will take too much time to do this one. So Jesus said, Amen, Amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold, church of God, where the royal priest ponder over his word through the gate, that does not allow the blasphemers like Ananias and Sapphira, or the Mammon-loving people, cheating people who cheat others, Judas Iscariot was, that Peter killed Ananias and Sapphira for telling their blasphemy, but climbs over elsewhere without being Mammon-free, without being checked, you know, is a thief. You can see that if you want to come go to your house, you go through your own gate, while the thief will jump over the wall to steal your money. And a robber, these hireling dog-collar priests in the churches, the synagogues of Satan. So these churches are synagogues of Satan, fulfilling Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. But whoever enters through the narrow gate meant for solitary, humble and solitary, with a childlike heart is the shepherd. Apostle of shepherd or apostle of the sheep. The gatekeeper, Saint Peter, opens it for him, and the sheep hear his voice as he calls his own sheep by name and leads them out to preach the gospel, to preach the bottom, rock bottom gospel truth. Gospel is rock bottom, right? There's nothing below that one. That is why Saint Thomas said, although we are solitary, but we are of one accord, because all of them have learned the gospel truth from the rock bottom, very basic. So all speak the same. At the Last Supper, they were so well qualified in their achievements that if a stranger come to know who is the Christ, he would not know. Remember that the Greek who came to Jerusalem, they wanted to speak to Christ Jesus. So they asked his laborers that we want to speak to Christ Jesus, because they did not know who is the Christ Jesus among them. So then they went to Jesus and told him that, oh, Jesus was so happy. He said, oh, there is somebody who is the customer of the gospel truth. Gospel truth is 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. Very rare people love it. All the love is the sugar-coated sermons of the psychic priest, dog-collar priest, Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing in their churches. Rock bottom gospel truth. When he has driven out all his own, that means into the world, to preach gospel, he, our bridegroom, walks ahead of them, giving them free will. If the rabbi, he go behind, that nobody go this way or that way. They are like sheep to be driven without any exception, no free will. By Jesus, he go ahead. Whoever likes him, he come. Whoever doesn't like, he can go home. And the people left him, many of them left him, because they found the sayings too hard for them. For our bridegroom walks ahead of them, giving them free will. And the sheep devoted to God of Holy Ghost accompany him, accompany. We join hands with Jesus. We don't follow like a blind man. So only the blind people follow others, but we join hands, accompany Jesus, and not follow as the blind do. Because they recognize his voice. So because we recognize his voice, and it is his voice which attracts us. But they will not follow a psychic stranger, psychic sugar-coated sermon, as you see them, these televangelists and other, as the once-born would gladly do. Once-born are very happy to follow them, because they deliver sugar-coated sermon. They paint a bright picture of heaven and everything, hell and so. Heaven and hell is here. Ask in India where the hell is, and they will tell you. Or other country with like suffering, you know, they are all hell and heaven here. So they will run away from him. So if they find a psychic who is cheating people, ask him for money. Remember, when the first church was formed, people sold their possessions to enter the church of God. And they did not ask for donations. or anything like that. And these people who ask for donation, they are anti-Christ. They are working for money, and the man who put on the dog collar and other thing, he's a parasite on the church, or he's a Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. He's not trustworthy. He loves money only, because they do not recognize the voice of strangers. When this, that's why St. Paul said, listen to everyone and let it in Holy Spirit. And what is good, take it. What is bad, throw it away. So these people, psychic, they give you sugar-coated sermon, which we don't like, because they give you sectarian voice. The sons of Most High Satan Al-Jumar Al-Aqsa, that is what they are, these are psychic people. Mostly for the lost Al-Jumar Al-Aqsa, who wanted to Muslim Brotherhood. Split yourself. The politics is a tribal affair, not religious affair. So anybody who incites people in the name of religion, he is Antichrist, and he is some Most High Satan, which dominates in this dark age, as the temple priests were, and who killed Christ Jesus. Although Jesus used this figure of speech, they did not realize what he was trying to tell them, because they did not like the sugar-coated sermons of the Satan. So Jesus said again, Amen, Amen, I say to you, I am the proper narrow gate to the royal vineyard of our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., of Sadhu Melchizedek, where your tribal identity by birth, where your tribal identity by birth or seed does not count, but the spiritual in karma or deeds for the sheep. So the, you know, in John the Baptist, here your tribal identity count, seed, here your deeds, your quality counts here, whether you are a blasphemer or a saint, are you giving good or leading them wrong or right, holy or evil spirited people. Judas Iscariot can't enter into, doesn't like this gate, so he keeps outside and make another fold, which is they have make another fold to give sugar-coated sermon to them. In Jesus, we have to see that those people who are have been taken by the Satan are attracted back to our Father, and we become one. So Antichrist is to be defeated. In Jesus, everyone has to give his own account to God. So you can't make a following, because you can't give his account to God. So anybody who make a following or anything, he's Antichrist, and he forms another fold. And we have to bring those people back to line, into the fold of our supernatural Father, our Church of God, in which people are solitary, royal priests. No priest there, no doctoral priest, or blind people. You can see their blindness in the churches when you go. They say in the prayer used to be to Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, and not in Christ Jesus, because in Jesus our Father is inside. Before the thing comes to our lip, he already knows what you want. So our Father is no more in heaven as Yahweh was, but inside here. So those people who say our Father in heaven, they are spiritually blind people. And their priests are dokkal priests. They are psychic, sugar-coated sermon. They are sons of the Satan, Al-Jimar al-Aqsa, creating sectarian riots. So if we have one God, and you believe in one God, there should not be interfaith. Because there will be one faith then, one God, one faith, not interfaith. So you can see how spiritually blind the people are. All who came before me, that means those prophets and other things, and these priests, rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, etc., delivering the sugar-coated sermons of falsehoods. Prophets did not give sugar-coated sermons. Prophets are whip master for the rabbis. Prophets are in Yahweh. Saints are in Elohim. All who came before me delivering the sugar-coated sermons of falsehoods are thieves asking for donations. They took tithe, you know, from the people, but they won't justify them, or they won't render them, give them justice. Bribery was going on. Rich man will give bribe and he will get the justice in his favor, and the poor man is robbed away. And this is quite common today. These ombudsmen and head of the organizations, they are blasphemers, they are running a mafia. They are cheating people, you know, and I have been cheated many times by these ones. I took the matter to the ombudsman and others because I'm educated, and I found that they are doing favor to their own client and not doing the justice. They are not righteous people. In God, we are righteous. Righteous are sons of the Most High. Unrighteous are the one who do the favor. Unrighteous, they are sons of Satan, and Satan is super bastard. Not born, people are born of legitimate parents, but their hearts are not for God, but for Satan. That's because they become super bastards. That's why Jesus told them in John 8, verse 44, to the Jews sitting there, who were become Jew outwardly and fanatic, that your forefathers are super bastard fanatic devils. And when he called them super bastard, then they retorted, we are born of legitimate parents. That is true, you are born of legitimate parents. But when you do favor or you do injustice, then you become super bastard. If you are righteous person, then you are sons of the Most High, saint. Otherwise, you are super bastard fanatic devils. And so are they create sectarian riots and all that thing. And thieves are asking for donations. When the first Church of God was formed or established, people sold their possessions to enter that fold of the royal priest. Fold of royal priest where there was fellowship. And robbers as Pope, who is the replacement of the temple high priest. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45 is fulfilled in this Pope, and his organization is living lavishly on the widow's mite. But the true twice born sheep did not listen to them. That means sheep to serve God. They knew that they are, when they test them, vet them in logically, what they find is not a logical thing what they are talking about. Illogical. They are thieves. They sugarcoat it suddenly. And like this, you know, like Church of England headed by Queen. Queen is head of Mammon. So anybody, you know, who thinks that Church of England is anything to do with God, he is a most stupid person. Church of England, how can you glorify God by killing and looting people? Salvation Army people say their people died for king and country in World War I and World War II and not to glorify God. So they speak the rock bottom gospel truth, but they hate them. St. Paul's Cathedral is full of the statues of Viceroy for India, General South Africa Viceroy, because they bring money. So, Church of England headed by Queen is the Church of Satan, Mammon. For the sake of Mammon, they will loot you, they will kill you. And you can see that the Queen's husband has died recently. But our husband, Church of God husband, which is our bridegroom, is eternal. He is never born, he never die. Christ is never born, never die, but Jesus was born, Jesus died on the cross. But the true twice born sheep did not listen to them, and they called them sinners, like the tax collector, you know, they were sensible people, and those rabbis who were babblers and liars and psychic, giving sugar-coated sermons, they won't go to attend this synagogue. When they do not go to attend the synagogue, because it is transgressing, it is against the moral laws, and that is why they were called sinners, not in any other way. So Mary Magdalene was called a sinner, and that Simon did not told that how much sin she had, but Jesus, you know, set her free of the moral laws, that is the seven demons, menorah, seven demon menorah. She was set free and gone into the Holy Spirit. So in Jesus, our morality does not count, but our conscience and our devotion to God counts. For not attending their synagogue on Sabbath, the tax collector, because they were not attending, they were calling them sinners, transgression against the moral of Moses. I am the narrow gate. For the brave, solitary, humble, sealed to serve God of Holy Ghost, whoever enters through me will be saved, as in this crisis of coronavirus, you know, crisis, if you preach gospel, enter the fold of our Supernatural Father, then you are, his mighty hand is on your head, so you are safe and sound, because you are protected by God and not by men, you know, protected by God, and will come in and go out enjoying the free will and find pastures of the royal priest. Pastures. Remember that Peter was fishing and he was casting his net to the left side of the boat. Left means gone. They are people who have gone. They don't want to know you. And then Jesus came and told him, Peter, have you caught any fish? No, no, we have been trying all the night, nothing. He said, okay, put the net to the right side of the boat. So he put the net on the right side, means people who are willing to listen to you. I put this, made this t-shirt, written all over there. Hardly anyone asked me, what is this, or they want to know more about it. And first of all, they feel inferiority complex. A white man asking a black man to tell him something. They think that because they ruled over India, so these black people have no brain. And that is what happened. One of the surveyor, my neighbor is a white person, and we had a boundary dispute. And boundary was, had a special drawing to the very centimeter accurate. And our markings were accurate. But my neighbor, you know, built a extension encroaching my bond, encroaching my land. So I hired a surveyor, and he showed the encroachment by the neighbor, and then the front line, he put it 4 foot into my court, forecourt. And then he asked me, your neighbor can have the encroachment if you give him my own forecourt, and he will give me back my forecourt. He will give me that. He make so much a fool of me. 4 foot line he draw into my forecourt. That land belongs to my neighbor. Even a stupid man can find that that is absolutely wrong. And that was a fellow of the Chartered Surveyor, Royal Institute of Chartered Surveyor, a fellow. And these Chartered Surveyors, Royal Institute, I spoke to other people doing the boundaries and other things. One of these surveyors, who was a Messianic Jew, he told me, Mr. Nidja, if somebody has done the boundary drawing for you, nobody will overturn it. So you should forget about it. You won't get justice. That means they are running a Freemason shop, these surveyors. So this is not the only one. All the obersmen I have found, they do the favor to their client who pay them the money, and they work as defense solicitor for them. Not obersmen, they are defense solicitor rather, to cheat people. That's why there are so many fraud going on in Britain. There's no end to it. So this is a mafia in disguise, government approved. So we'll come in and go out enjoying free will and find pasture of the royal priest. Royal priest mean honest people, righteous people, who established churches in which you give the in which you give to the church, you know, so that people, like in Sikh temple you go, people bring milk, food and other things. They cook it there and anybody can have free meal, no charges. So in church, you know, you should have free meal for the people. They can come and enjoy the free meal. But every church over there, if there's a meal, you know, they charge you £2, £3, £5, or make profit out of it. Opposite. So establish churches in which you give to the church and not take out of the church as as the hireling dog collar priest of Satan do as their salaries. They are hypocrites. They are not men of God. They are men of Mammon, money. Sorry, a thief of the type of Judas Iscariot, who used to steal money from the purse, as these hireling dog collar priests, especially in the Church of England, who become lords. They are, you know, in the Church of England, these priests are very proud that one day they will rise to the job of bishop, and when they become bishop, they can sit in the House of Lords. Very high position they can get. Whereas the other churches, Salvation Army people and others, no, they don't want to know them. So this is a Church of Satan, you know, that's why the Obersmen and all those people, they are Satan. So Lords comes only to steal. The thief people, you know, asking for money and other things, donations and other things, they come to steal money, as Judas Iscariot was stealing money from the purse, as their salaries and wages and then frauds and other things, which they glorify by killing and looting people. Then they will happily, the thief, you know, Judas Iscariot in thief's clothing, when the queen's soldiers, they will expand the empire, you know. Oh, they will be very happy that their ruling power has gone up and they will get more money. And when their soldier dies, they happily say they glorified God. So what type of God was that who was glorified with killing and looting people? That is Satan, not God. That is hypocrisy. And slaughter and destroy as the sons of Most High Satan, Jews outwardly, the temple priest, are doing today. Today, you know what is happening in the world, is the Jewish, the American Jews, who have the Mammon and media of Satan, bloodsuckers, they are destroying one country after the other. And they started with Iraq, the homeland of their forefather, Abram, a good rootstock Yahweh bring to plant it in the Middle East at Adam, Sarah as Eve, promised land was at Garden of Eden. So that people through them learn the moral laws. That's why they are called nation of priests or gods. Jews outwardly are doing today, depicted by an MP. I will put a link to that post cartoon and you can see it. There is the cartoon here, which was put by a MP. And as soon as the paper realized that it is against them, it was put in the Jewish newspaper. Here's the man with the American flag holding a sickle with David's cross, and that is what he is doing, bloodshed from one country to the other. That is MP did it. He is the deputy head. You can see deputy head of the Green Party. So these MPs, they know in their heart what is happening, but they are not allowed to speak because gospel is bitter. And if somebody speaks gospel, they can't get vote, no vote. So they, for the sake of vote, they have to deliver sugar-coated sermon. So they become sons of the Most High Satan themselves. So that's why you must carry your own cross if you want to preach gospel. And then you have to be solitary, not making a following like MPs and other people. You can't do it. Most High Satan, Jews outwardly are doing today, depicted by an Green Party MP. I came so that they among whom Christ Jesus came, the Jews outwardly, sons of Satan, tears, Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30, might have life, are given a chance to earn their redemption and have it more abundantly through the knowledge of the Oral Torah, the taproot of the tree of this life, tree of life, the scripture. Here I depicted that one. So, here the tree of life, basically this is scripture. And this is the taproot and this is the Oral Torah. If this Oral Torah is missing, then this root is dead. Then this scripture is dead. They can corrupt it as they like it. They can make a lot of holes in the scripture. Among the Samaritans, this taproot was green, not dead. So their scripture was perfect, no holes in it. And that's why they had 5 talents. Where the temple priests, they had 2 talents, and they spent on wine and women, or lavish living. And they were a liability. And the Samaritan, they were assets. They were credit to God. And they were liability. So among the Samaritan, this was green. And that's why Samaritan man picked up the wounded person. Whereas the Pharisee and Rabbi passed by, no concern with the man. Because we're thinking, hey, he's not our man, he's a stranger. And as a stranger, they left him. But in God, our soul is concerned, not the physical body. So we exercise love called agape, unconditional divine love. So, through the knowledge of the Oral Torah, that means abundantly through the knowledge of the Oral Torah, because Oral Torah is lacking nothing. Oral Torah is lacking nothing, this one. It's not dependent upon anything, but this scripture is dependent upon this one. So scripture is lacking Oral Torah. And that's why Jesus came to deliver the Oral Torah, to make thee to fulfill the scripture, or to fulfill the moral laws, not to destroy it, uphold it. Through the knowledge of the Oral Torah, the taproot of the tree of life, the scripture, as the generation of Joseph, the Samaritans enjoyed, and they possessed 5 talents. Remember the parable of the 10 talents. One was given 5, the other one 2, and one was given 1 who was once more. Clever people had 2, and they spent on lavishly, as told in the prodigal son parable. So they were liability, and the one was given to those who were just keeping the scripture, that this is the word of God. And this new, you know, they have got the Gnostic Gospels. They found the scripture, these, what they call them, Gnostic Gospel and other, you know, they found their old writing. That's Dead Sea Scrolls and other things. Now those are there, but these people in the universities, they are dead in letters. and they have no Holy Spirit. So no Holy Spirit means they can't interpret it. There's a well said parable of no go of St. Thomas. Unless a female becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. And they have no idea of this one. How the female can become a male. They are always thinking in this physical self, not spiritual self. And I wrote to them and told them I can explain to you, but they don't want to know me because I have no degree in theology. In Keble College, Oxford, I used to attend New Testament seminars. And then they wrote to me that I can't attend it because I don't have a MA or PhD degree in theology. So they banned me from that. Recently, in another college, Bellier College, I was attending a Christian-Jewish seminar for 2 days. And I went there and I sat in the room listening to the speaker. And suddenly the head of that seminar came, seeing me with this t-shirt, hoodie. Then she called me after the, come. I went there. She took me outside and told me, you can't attend this seminar because students don't like this light. This is light on living lampstand. They don't like it. So they say, okay, what you have underneath? Underneath I have a t-shirt which has the same thing. So they told me, no, you can't attend it. They bring my bag and they throw me out. You can't come here. So this is how they hate you, you know. The light came among his own, and his own loved darkness. Such are the university professors, and I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. And they get annoyed. And they told me that our duty is to teach them the scripture, the dead letters of Old and the New Testament. The interpretation is up to the student. It is not our affair, which is right, you know, because interpretation you get by the grace of our Supernatural Father. You can't have it without that one. And that's why they all are flying dead letters. Let the dead bury their dead in seminars, in speeches, and in other things. What they do, you know, writing papers and all that this man said, that man said, and he himself doesn't know because gospel gets written over your heart and not in dead book letters. So, sorry, like scripture, as the generation of Joseph, the Samaritan enjoyed, and they possess 5 talents, ready to multiply to 10. By preaching the gospel truth, which is the St.Photina, that lady, you know, at the well, she was named St.Photina. And in Oxford University, I asked them, what do you think of that woman which had 5 husbands? Oh, she was a sinner. And those 5 were spiritual. And I told them, these are their names, spiritual names, which are immorality, then anger, then greed, then worldly attraction, and the last one is haughtiness of spiritual knowledge. But she had learned the spiritual knowledge through Holy Spirit. She wasn't opening a Bible to ask questions to Jesus, like John 9, born blind person, when he was asking the priest questions, he didn't open the Bible up. He was frightened of them. He was brave. And so was this Samaritan woman. She was not opening any Bible or anything to ask questions. Their questions were coming from her heart. Through the knowledge written over her heart, she was asking questions. And then he told them, you look to be a prophet. Then she told him, when the She told Jesus that when Christ comes, he will tell us everything. She knew the difference between a prophet and Christ. That means Christ is higher than prophet. So then Jesus was so happy to tell her that he is the Christ. When he said so, then she left the water and went to her village to proclaim that I have found the Christ. But don't believe me, go and wet him yourself, because you have to get Christ in your heart yourself by wetting, not by saying this man said, that man said, but by wetting. I have Christ in my heart. I preach Christianity. I'm not a Christian. I'm a Christ. I'm a Gnostic. Gnostics are living Christ. And these people dead in book, they call us heretic because they can't understand the gospel truth. So the male, the female become a male is here that under this rabbis, under rabbis, you have no free will. As a woman has no free will, husband is the master of the house. So Saul had no free will under Gamaliel. So Saul was a female. And when Jesus at Damascus gate opened his eye and showed him the real things, and when he realized that one, how blind he was with the thickness of the scale that came off his eyes, then when he realized that one, that how wrong he was doing, persecuting the laborers of Jesus, because his rabbi, Gamaliel, told him to do so. So he changed the name of his wife. This is wife. Alright, he changed the name of wife Saul to Paul. Remarried it. You know, when a wife, you divorce it, she marry another husband, she become Mrs. So-and-so. So same way, Saul, when he was married to Gamaliel, then she did what Gamaliel told him to do. But when he became independent, then Saul took back his wife and changed the name to Paul. Because soul has no name, you know, soul, the name of the soul go by this body. So the Saul, when he became independent, master of his own destiny, free of Gamaliel, then he changed the name of his physical body, wife, to Paul. Remember Matthew 19, the marriage and divorce, the Pharisee Sadducee. They were asking the question based upon the moral laws of man marrying a woman, two people. But Jesus gave them the spiritual counterpart. That for this reason, man is the soul. So this is the soul man here. We are all sons of the Most High. For this reason, man leaves his mother and father God to join his wife flesh. Flesh is the wife. In the womb of the woman on conception. This marriage you can't see, but you perceive it. And they are no more two, but one person. But these priests in the churches, when they marry man and the woman, they say, oh, you are no more two, but one, but I can still see them too. So you can see how the Bible is misinterpreted. So our Father God bless you in agape. This is the agape. The arrows under Moses, agape under Christ Jesus, filial love, philosophical, at Pentecost when they became the sons of the Most High, with capital S, and they have blessed with the Holy Spirit, they became a love called Storji love. Storji love. And much more in my other videos. Not many customers, you know. But time is coming, people will be coming because this coronavirus, because atomic war is expected on 14 May 2023. So you will see a lot of tribulation in this world. So if you want to be on safe side, then carry your own cross. Then carry your own cross and preach gospel from the rooftop. Not looking left and right. The other people will join you, because when you are running a race, then you don't look that let the other person come and join you, but you run solitary, solo, one only on your own, independent. So you have to carry the cross independent, solitary basis. Then you can enter this narrow gate into the royal kingdom of God. Our supernatural Father bears everyone in agape, the base of our royal kingdom.